Hey, welcome back. Great to see ya. Today's Workflow Wednesday is a little bit different. We're talking about the layout of your Adobe Premiere. There's like so many things going on. There's folders and effects and timelines and videos and everything. I'm gonna show you guys how I lay it out. You know what? It might be a Workflow Wednesday just for me, because you might have a specific way you wanna do it. That's totally fine. I'm just showing you how I do it to maximize my efficiency and make sure I know where everything is so I can edit as quickly as possible. Better workflow. It's Workflow Wednesday. All right, let's get this baby going. It's straightforward. This is probably gonna be the quickest Workflow Wednesday because I'm just pointing stuff out. Like I said before, it's a preference thing. At the end of this video, if you find like something different, you might have a sick way of doing it, now that I think of it. If you have a better way of doing this, make sure you comment down below. Let's get into what I do. If we're looking at Adobe Premiere here, first and foremost, you gotta have the window with what you're working on. If you don't have the preview window, do you even know what you're editing? Are you so elite at editing you don't even have to look at the footage to know what you're doing? I'd be very impressed to know somebody who did that. Boom, nice big preview window. We can see what's going on. On the left side here, we've got our effect controls. This is where when you drag a clip onto the timeline, you can see, you know, the position, scale, rotation. Any effects that you add to that clip will come up on that left side. I like that to be like, you know, relatively large so I can play with the numbers and see the difference all at the same time. Right below that, we've got our project panel. This is where all your clips are imported. How you organize your clips is a whole other Workflow Wednesday that I should probably film. But that's also up to you. Do you want a list view? Do you want a grid view? That's all goes in there. I like to keep that relatively big, usually about 4 or 5 clips across so I can get a preview of what I'm looking at. That works for me, might not work for you. Now, working on a large screen, I have the benefit of a larger timeline. I think if I was working on a laptop, I'd sacrifice, you know, some of the other areas, make them smaller so I have more timeline. It's very frustrating if you have like a little strip of timeline and you have to constantly keep scrubbing through to see where you are and just a nice big timeline. I think that's universally accepted. I think we can all agree on that, right guys? Right? Right? Okay, moving on. And then on the right side of the screen, we've got our effects, graphics, lumetri panel. So this is where, you know, you just type into the search bar whatever effects you need and you drag them onto your timeline, as well as the lumetri color panel that allows you to color grade and correct your footage if you shot too dark, if you shot too bright, if it's too cool, too warm. This I use quite a bit, so I think the fact that it needs to take up a little bit of real estate is important. But again, that's just for me. That being said, if you have the luxury of operating on dual monitors, that changes the whole game. You can have a whole screen just for your preview panel. You can have preview and timeline on the one and then all your effects on the other. I'm genuinely curious, what do you guys do? What are some like tips and tricks that you have for your Adobe Premiere workflow that, you know, gets everything in one spot and makes it most efficient for you? Comment down below. If you like this video, if you're like, hey Dan, sweet workflow. I love the way you set up your Premiere. I'm gonna do that too. Make sure you hit that like button. Subscribe if you're not already. Same old YouTuber ending stuff, but you gotta do it. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Love ya.